Burn, a really good way to avenge, sorry, the defeat at Tynecastle. What did you make of today?
Very impressive. I just, the only unfortunate thing was we didn't win by a greater margin. I thought 3-2 flattered Hearts, and the number of chances that we had, you know, they took the two chances they got, but we had double figures and really should have been a more emphatic scoreline. But yeah, just great to get the victory. Cup games all about winning, aren't they? So
everybody said this would be a good gauge for us a fortnight after getting beat at Tynecastle, and can you see the progress just in that short space of time?
It's unrecognisable, you know, between the two teams. I think what a difference, particularly Kyogo's made coming in, the energy level he brings to the team, sensational. Bit of stability at the back with the keeper, even the subs coming on today, you know, just great. The whole stadium's taken a lift from the fans being back in. We were impacted more than any other team, we all said that, nobody believed us, but it's been proven now with the fans getting the back of the team. What a great week it's been.
You can really see that Kyogo's such a key piece of the puzzle for Ange, can't you?
He's got everything. He's got absolutely everything. We knew he had skill. People questioned if he could play as a number nine. You know, did he have you know, the strength to play that? Could he win the ball? He's like a wee terrier. He never gives up. You know, I think I was talking to a few of the boys during the week about when was the last time you seen a player who had that amount of energy and appetite. I think he goes far back.
Kicked up and down today as well.
Oh, kicked up and down. And it doesn't bother, it doesn't faze him. He's never moaned the ref. He just gets on with it. And I think Petrov and players like that, we've not had that many in the last few years. It's been more people will fall down and they'll be lethargic. But he's not just brought energy as an individual, he's got those around about him thinking, wait a minute, I better do a little bit more here. So they're all running. I mean, Eddie today, the energy level he brought today was incredible.
Fantastic. James McCarthy comes on for his debut. That means Callum McGregor moves up one. Do you think if McCarthy's going to stay fit, he would be first choice? And if so, who do you drop out of that midfield? Because they're all playing really well at the minute.
Well, that's a toughie, and I wouldn't like to pick that. I'm just delighted that we've now got a decision to make there, because before you were struggling to get, you know, your three or your four in midfield. Now we've got options. I think you've got options now wide and in the middle. I'd love to see McGregor pushing up a wee bit. When McCarthy came on today, there was a presence about him. I don't know if it was just his height, but he just thought, wow, he looks a player, doesn't he? So I'm hoping he stays fit and he features week in, week out. He certainly brings a lot of experience to the team.
Can you pick a man of the match today?
Oh, man of the match, that's a toughie. I think my man of the match for the rest of the season is going to be Kyogo. He's just so good, isn't he? I thought Turnbull was good, Roger was good. I'm going to give it to Kyogo because, you know, his goal was sensational. He was involved in one of the other goals as well. He's just, when he went off, you felt the impact of him going off as well, eh? So
he came at a really important time, the third goal as well.
It did come at an important time. It was just disappointing, even just to lose that last goal. To lose 1-1, 3-1 was okay, but 3-2 is just a bit disappointing. Those that weren't at the game won't realise what a dominant game it was. By Kyogo for me, definitely.